right. It's 8:58, 2 minutes before 9 o'clock, and we have a whole studio full of WHUD employees here, and they brought me a beautiful cake that says, Best Wishes, Ed.
Who's gone jumping out of the cake? It's not that big a cake.
Not that big a cake.
The only one who would fit in there is George, and he just called, so I know it's not him.
Stop picking on George.
No, George just called to wish you happy. John Noach just called. Eric Gross wanted a call. I've been trying to get him on the phone, but I can't get him because he said he worked with you back in WMCA days.
That's right. He was one of our traffic reporters.
Yeah. So Eric says the very best. And there are people on hold. I mean, you're never going to get out of here. Somebody wants to say something?
Steve Patron is here.
We have a lot of the staff here, but I thought it'd be appropriate for me to say a couple of words as the program director of WHUD. First of all, Ed, thank you for 14 great years on the station. You and before you, Joe O'Brien. You and Joe set the standard that all of us here in this building strive for, and I've had the privilege of programming the station with two legends in radio broadcasting, and I'm extremely happy that you'll be continuing with us. Ed is not going away. He will be with us every Sunday, Pop Rewind, 10 a.m. Sunday morning, so we hope everyone will tune in. And, you know, to our listeners, a few words. You know, they keep. We've gotten so many faxes and emails and everyone wondering what's going to happen now with Ed away from the mornings. Well, you know, 14 years ago, Joe O'Brien gave up mornings, and we brought Ed Baer to the Hudson Valley, and you can't replace Ed. We know that, but we will try to follow the standards that you and Joe have set, and we received many emails wishing you well, and one that caught my attention came from Kathy McCarthy, who said, I always enjoy your show. I especially like it because you are never mean-spirited or rude or vulgar like so many radio shows. Well, Ed, my pledge to you and to our listeners is to keep our morning show with Mike Bennett and the team that we're building a fun morning show, one that the whole family can listen to, and really based on the foundations that you and Joe built. And I think there's no better tribute to you than to do that. And Ed, the best to you and to Pearl, and we love you.
Well, thank you, Steve, and thanks to everybody in the studio this morning. You've been like family to me, and what can I say on this last day of the Ed Baer affair? I want to make it clear, and a lot of people said, wow, did he get fired? You know, happened all of a sudden? No, this was my decision. I was not asked to leave, and I don't want to get sad about this day, but I'm about to. Tomorrow will be the first day of the rest of my life, and Monday morning, I'm going to get to sleep late. If my wife lets me. I'll miss you all very much, and I hope we had a few laughs over the last 14 years. And for the last time, Ed Baer saying thanks so much for listening. My best to the family, and we'll have to have lunch sometime. And as I ride off into the sunset, what better way to close the show with the late King of the Cowboys, Roy Rogers.